old-fashioned, if you like, public health approaches to limit viral transmission, such as what happened with 1918, right? The original Spanish flu in 1918, which is the first recognized, what we recognize now as the first influenza pandemic. So, but this, if you look at the history of that, and there's some really nice work that's been done by medical historians analyzing what happened during that time, you can see human behavior hasn't changed that much, because you see these curves where transmission declined, right? And then people became fed up with being kept inside and being restricted so much. And so they started to go out again. And also public health officials said, yes, transmission has declined. We can start to move out a bit more. And then once people started to become more used to being out again, and then cases started to increase because of course they were mingling more, they actually didn't want to listen to the instruction to go back home, right? So they said, oh no, I don't think so. So they continued to go out, and that's directly so linked to the increase in cases, so kind of a second wave of infections. So you can kind of see the same thing starting to happen around you if you're not careful.